In this video, I'll show a quick way to construct your own modifiable normal curve. Let's first create the standard normal curve in Excel. I'm going to create a column for z values starting at negative 4, then negative 3.9. Select both and drag all the way to positive 4. Then for the curve, I'm going to use num.s.dist. I'm going to select the first z value here, comma, then for cumulative, I'll type 0 or false. Enter. I'm going to grab the handle and double-click to auto-fill the entire column. Next, I'm going to select the column titles and Ctrl-Shift down arrow to select both columns. I'm going to click Insert, Scatter, and then choose the one with smooth lines. Next, I'll copy the chart and open a blank PowerPoint presentation. I'm going to select all and delete. Next, click the arrow under the paste here and paste special. Select picture, enhanced meta file, and click OK. And here we have the curve as a grouped meta file object. Now press Ctrl+Shift+G to ungroup it. It will ask if you want to convert to a drawing object. Click Yes. Now Ctrl+Shift+G to ungroup it again. I'm going to click away from the graph. Now there's a visible border here and two invisible ones. Click on the border area 3 times and delete them all. Next, I'll delete the grid lines. And then the labels. Next, I'm going to select the curve and press Ctrl+D to duplicate it. I'm going to drag the duplicate up here. Now, to shade some regions under the curve, I can select a rectangle drawing tool here. Drag and draw a rectangle to the desired Z values. Next, select the rectangle and Ctrl+click to select the curve as well. Under Shape Format, click Merge Shapes. Then click Fragment to break the shape into different parts. Next, I'm going to duplicate this slide for different shading options. So to shade details, I can delete the rectangle in the middle, along with a residual line at the bottom here. I'm going to select the left tail and Ctrl+click to select the right tail as well. Right-click, click Outline, No Outline. Next, I'll drag down the curve at the top onto the shaded areas. If I only want the right tail shaded, I can simply delete the left tail. Next, I'll go to the duplicate I created earlier to keep the middle region shaded. I'm going to delete the top here, delete the right tail area, delete the left tail area as well, delete the line at the bottom of the shaded area, right-click on the shaded area to remove the outline, then drag down the curve and nudge it into place. And that's it. Thanks for watching.